Hello, I'm Shamalina Ghosh, and today I am going to talk about a global analysis of community stability, freshwater versus terrestrial realms.
I am motivated by the long-standing debate in community ecology, the diversity-stability relationship. The usual expectation is community stability should increase with diversity or species richness. This relationship is also influenced by the interspecific interactions. So similarly behaving species make community more synchronous, thus more variable or less stable. But this interspecific interaction could be asymmetric due to extreme events. So my question is how community stability differs across realms and influenced by these asymmetric interactions. So what do we mean by symmetric interactions? Here you can see the red and the blue line representing type series of two species which are fluctuating similarly. So overall synchronous. If you plot the rank of individual time series along x and y axis, you will see this scatter plot with positive significant correlation but with no tail dependence. Now, with the asymmetric interaction, you can see that these two species time series are now strongly correlated at their either extreme. In the top panel, you can see that two species are more correlated in their lower values, so the rank plot shows a strong correlation in its lower tail. Similarly, in the bottom pattern, you can see that two species are strongly correlated in their higher values, so there is a strong tail dependence in the rank plot in its upper tail. So we can quantify synchrony, not just measuring correlation, because the three plots have the same positive correlation. So we should measure the tail asymmetry to quantify synchrony, and we can do it by taking the difference of tail dependence in its lower tail and its upper tail. For our study, we have collected individual species level data from 2,560 communities. The data is hierarchical with 7 taxa nested within 2 realms. So for the method, for each community, we considered pairwise interaction of the species which were present at least for 70% of study period with minimum study period of 20 years. This is our effective species richness R. We also measured the fraction of lower tail dependent and upper tail dependent pairwise species interactions in each community. The total number indicates the total asymmetry for that community, and their difference indicates the net asymmetry in that community. We computed variance ratio and skewness ratio with the considered species time series. The variance ratio is defined as the ratio of temporal variance of total biomass for a given community with respect to the temporal variance of total biomass if the species were independent. Similarly, for the skewness ratio, it is the temporal skewness of total biomass scaled with respect to the temporal skewness of total biomass if the species were independent. For skewness ratio, we would recommend you to take a look on our recently accepted paper. So after initial data exploration, we can see terrestrial realm has higher stability and higher species richness than freshwater realms. The variance ratio are quite similar between these two realms. So here we are showing model setup only for two taxa, birds and fish, as they are the dominant in terrestrial and freshwater realms respectively. For the basic model, we have considered only the two predictors, the usual richness and the variance ratio for predicting the stability for each taxa, and for the alternate model we have considered all the five predictors: the richness, variance ratio, total asymmetry, net asymmetry and skewness ratio. We are using BRMS-R package for the Bayesian mixed effect modeling. So the result from the model comparisons in bird shows that stability is better predicted in that alternate model, as the R square values are much better than the R square values from the basic model, and also richness has that significant positive effect on stability, and variance ratio has a significant negative effect on stability, and the total asymmetry A has significant negative effect in the stability for birds. Also, the loose statistics showed that alternate model has better weightage than that basic model. We also got the similar result in fish as that of bird. That is, the alternate model is better in predicting the variation in stability than the basic model. So in conclusion, as you can see that preliminary result shows freshwater communities are less stable than terrestrial communities, and asymmetric interactions in community plays important role in assessing community stability. We are aiming to build a full hierarchical Bayesian model involving whole dataset to confirm our finding with significance. Thank you for all your attention.